A hearty welcome, Mr. Kachru. It's indeed an honor for me to be sharing the dais with you, and I'm sure we have half an hour of very interesting talk and insights ahead. You know, there's no point introducing Mr. Kachru to this audience because each one of you knows him. But today, the whole idea of this morning session is to getting to know about Mr. Kachru when he wasn't that famous, when he was the first person from Jammu and Kashmir to join the hospitality industry. He became a student of the Indian of IHM Pusa. In which year, sir?
Suresh, first of all, thank you, and to you and the audience, you will have to bear with my sore throat today, and I'm slightly under the weather, but
thank you so much for coming despite that.
You know, tolerate me a little bit. Promised myself that I'm going to be nice, and I want you to be nice to me. Well, I actually joined this profession by accident. Many will actually wonder what is an accident. I come from a state, as Suresh said, which is big time in tourism, at least domestically. And like any middle-class family, your parents, at least in those days, you know, they wanted their kids to be doctors or engineers. And my parents didn't think anything different. So they wanted me to become a doctor. And I really was not a very good student, I must admit. I did my pre-med and just managed it. I came to Delhi for a holiday to my sister's place. I read a board somewhere which said hotel management, and I still remember the bus I took, bus number 48 from South Extension, and landed myself in a Barsati which had French classes for hotel management. So I thought that was the institute. Later on, I managed to find out where Pusa is, and I went to Pusa. I am from third batch, and it was a really great infrastructure from the point of view of, I think it was ahead of times. When I look back,
who was the principal at Pusa at that time? And which year was this? The third batch?
We had Mr. Mith Bandar.
Okay.
He was Mr. Sims had gone back. We had expat as our principal, but he had gone back to England, and Mr. Mith Bandar took over, and it really wasn't that difficult to get admission those days. I was an average student. I managed it. So,
so what was the criterion then that you should be able to talk English, and you know, what did they really expect you to do at the interview or the entrance exam stage, or did they have an entrance exam then?
Well, they had an entrance exam. I think it was governed. It was under the Ministry of Food and Agriculture those days, and they had an entrance exam and a high-powered interview block. I still remember we had Mr. Ram Prasad, the likes of Mr. Ram Prasad.
He's the person who owned the Ambassador Hotel.
Absolutely, yeah. And he was president of the Hotel Federation of India.
Right.
Very prominent person, very respectable person. And he interviewed me. Right. I still remember a ketchup bottle. They were having some snacks while we were being grilled. And he asked me, do you know how to make ketchup? Okay. Well, sir, I have come to actually learn that. And that was my interview.
Oh, really?
Okay. Yeah. So easy days.
Right.
So that's how I started.
Right. And, you know, I believe what you were, I gathered from you, those were really early days. And, you know, what was the training that you were given, the academic training? Because the Indian hotel industry then was really in its infancy. I mean, there's not much to write home about in terms of number of hotels or, you know, the tradition of hoteliering. What training did you get? You know, was it a very French, very European style, or did they try to infuse some Indian elements too? You know?
I think it was very English, because most of the time, Ajampusa at least was governed by people and managed by people who were from UK. And those days, a lot of students used to be sent to Blackpool and Portsmouth. So we had a lot of influence of that. There was not much of Indian element there, except that we were taught Hyderabadi keema in the very first year.
Any particular reason for that, Hyderabadi keema?
I don't know. But it was interesting. It was interesting. And I think college had the, surprisingly, college had the infrastructure. I remember during our times, they imported a chapati making machine, which used to turn out about 30,000 chapatis an hour. You know, so we had the infrastructure, but I wish interaction with the industry would have been better. I think
that's a complaint even now. You know, there's very little interaction with the industry, isn't it?
I think things have improved a lot, and the principal Alok is doing a very good job,
yes.
I must
say. And he's from the industry, isn't he?
Yeah, he's from Pusa.
Yeah.
He's from Pusa. I'm still connected. I'm actually the chairman of the alumni association as well. And I think college is doing a good job. The ministry is helping out. Yeah. And alumni, you know, at the end of the day, what really matters is what kind of students are you producing and how are they placed.
Right.
So if the placement is good, the institute gets a good name. And Suresh, I think you are aware of this, that Pusa has been rated as number one hotel management school of the country.
Yes, and Pusa graduates are doing well, not only in India, they're all over. I mean, they're now heading international corporations. And they're doing the right at the top.
Yes, yeah. I know of at least three people who worked with me.
Yeah.
Are chief executives of three international hotel brands.
Wow, who are they?
One is Raj Rana,
right.
who's
now the CEO.
Yeah, who would be amongst you? Yeah. We have Puneet Chhatwal.
Right.
And we have Prasoon Mukherjee.
Right.
Deepak was also from our older batch.
Right.
And he also had a stint in Chennai.
Right.
He is CEO of Labua.
Right, right.
So you have Steigenberger.
Yeah.
You have Labua. Yeah. You have a big Indonesian Salim Group, which
right.
has multiple hotels.
Right.
So
right.
So it makes you feel very happy. Right. And we have, look at Sanjeev.
Right.
I mean, he is somebody who's the true ambassador of Indian cuisine.
Exactly.
Sanjeev has done a fantastic job.
Right, right. Yes, sir. And in fact, we have some distinguished alumni in the audience too. No? you know, you were also, I believe, the Student Association president. So you had a little bit of a union leader stint also. Can you tell us something about that bit? You know?
Yes, I was the president of the Student Association, and I think it helped me develop myself as a leader and do something for our profession. And I'm very proud to say our batch was the first batch where campus recruitment started.
Oh, really? Okay.
Yeah. We never had campus recruitment in any of the colleges. Mm-hmm. It was the first batch of management trainees.
Oh, interesting. So it's quite a memorable batch. Who are some of your batchmates?
You know? You know, I don't want to give my age, but from my batch, I don't see many people here, yeah. But we have alumni has a lot of representation in all the brands.
Right, yeah. Right, right. That's true. I think you joined the Shok as an industrial trainee.
As a management trainee.
As a management trainee, yeah.
Slightly better.
Okay, right. So in those days, I think everyone had to begin either at the Oberoi or the Ashok. What made you choose the Ashok, or what brought you to the Ashok?
You know, there were only three companies which used to offer right opportunities. It was Oberoi's, Taj, and Ashok, ITDC. ITDC was evolving, and I didn't get selected in Oberoi's. I wanted to join Oberoi's, but I couldn't get there. I got selected in Taj and ITDC both, and had to make a choice. My father used to work for the government. And I'm sure you realize, and particularly being a Kashmiri, you know, job security was a huge thing. They said, you will have job forever. So I think that that was the push I got, and I have no regrets. I think it was a great journey.
Yeah, you know, if you see the Ashok today, you know, it's like almost become a joke, you know. But there was a time in your time when everyone used to, like, Ashok was almost a benchmark for hospitality for the country, and it was producing, actually it was being poached heavily by every hotel that was coming up, you know. What was it in your time in those days? And are there any people you remember who may had a formative influence on you?
Well, I think as far as I remember, 90% of my time, we had great flexibility. I honestly, it may be hard to believe, I actually never felt that I was working for the government. We were allowed to do what we did. And it was the only organization which was actually developing new sectors, new places where private sector wouldn't go. You have so many locations in India which wouldn't have been on the tourist map, whether domestic or international, had it not been for ITDC. I think it was...
I think Khajuraho is one of the examples. Yeah, yeah.
Khajuraho is one of the many. Manali, Khajuraho, yeah. Trichy,
right.
Jammu,
right.
You know.
Exactly.
It wouldn't have been there. So, and I'm really proud to say a lot of my colleagues who left ITDC, in fact, I'm sure there must be some people here from ITC. ITC was established by ITDC. We had our head of the hotels at that time, Mr. Gadok, went and set up. The first general manager of Moria went from GM Akbar, KK Malhotra. We had our own management training badge, Noni Chawla, and Divesh Bhargav, OP Munjal.
All
ITDC, they were part of us. We were all together in the company.
The joke was that the ITC was actually ITDC minus the D. You know?
They have done a fantastic job.
Yeah.
And I think things changed over the years. The good thing was the competition came, and people excelled themselves. All other brands moved with the pace and accepted the market, change in the market and dynamism, which unfortunately didn't happen in ITDC, but otherwise a great organization. And it gave opportunity. I mean, I must tell you, I became a general manager when I was 23.
Wow, where were you?
I was Aurangabad, and although it was a small 80-room hotel, I became a general manager when I was 23. I became the general manager of the flagship Ashok Hotel when I was 28.
Wow.
I don't think people would have imagined that this can happen in government. I mean, at 28, and believe me, I was when this offer was made to me, to be the general manager, I was scared. I had 80 unions to handle, and out of 80 unions, there were at least 16 of them which were politically affiliated. There were INTAC, ITAC, CPI, CPU, and I had member of parliaments who were actually their presidents coming to negotiate, and they used to say, "We have come to negotiate with a kid." Went through that, and I think I learned a lot.
And how long, you know, because Aurangabad, I think your competition was Rama International, you know?
Rama and Ambassador.
Ambassador, okay. And both were, by that time, established hotels. And, But in Delhi, it was still a very raw scene. I mean, there was a Taj. Had Taj come up when you were...
No, Taj Palace was not there. Yeah. Taj Mansingh was not there.
Yeah, only Oberoi was there. The two Oberois.
Oberoi and Ashok. Ashok was actually, you correctly said it, yeah. It was a benchmark. Mm-hmm. I remember a little later, you know, there was a time when there were only two, three of us. Mm-hmm. But I remember just before the non-aligned, which was held, ultimately held in India, one day...
It was 1982, I think.
Yeah, yeah. In 80s, early 80s, yeah. I got a call from Prime Minister's office that there's something, Prime Minister would like to talk to you and your MD. Yeah. Mr. Rajan Jaitley, you probably know of him. Yeah. He was later chairman of Air India, managing director of Air India. So both of us were summoned. They said that non-aligned was to be held in Iraq, and the world body has taken a decision it will not be held there. So option is we do it. And between non-aligned and Chogham, we'll get 110 heads of state. And Ashok had only... actually, it had about over 100 suites.
Right.
We had those days. I don't know what is the latest figure now. So they said that we want to do it in India. And our hotel was not in a condition to host 110 heads. And we were just given 4 months. Just 4 months. And I mean, we felt very good when it went off so well.